first light off the east coast of New Zealand. Naval units from Australia and New Zealand, two South Pacific nations of the British Commonwealth, carry out maneuvers under the command of Rear Admiral Eccles, flying his flag in the light fleet carrier HMAS Sydney. Coming at a time of great tension at various points in the Pacific, the maneuvers exercise Force 75 before ships are dispersed to patrol New Zealand's and Australia's widely scattered island dependencies. Other units are going north to join the United States fleet in support of Southern Korea. No modern fleet can fight without rapid means of detection and communication. HMNZS Bellona keeps in touch with ships about her by light and flag hoists. Powerful radio equipment allows her to speak and listen to the Admiralty in London or Navy office in Melbourne and Wellington. During the exercises, highly sensitive radar antennas search the sky. Other aerials sweep the surface, sending a picture of what lies below the horizon to screens in different parts of the ship. Beneath the ship, ASDIC sets probe under the sea for submarines. First reports come from radar screens. Enemy cruiser 70 miles away. Enemy submarine on the surface 50 miles. Ships, men have gone to action stations. Sydney's wireless aerials go down in readiness for Sea Furies and Fireflies to take off, intercept the enemy, and provide air cover over Force 75. Turning into the wind and keeping a steady course to fly off her planes, the carrier's now at a disadvantage against any submarine waiting to attack. Enemy submarine Telemachus detects approaching planes and crash dives. Having reported the movements of Force 75, she must now try to escape. At periscope depth, the submarine captain takes a last look round.
Starboard 20.
Starboard 20, sir.
20 starboard wheel on. Midships.
Midships.
430.
430, sir.
34,
we want.
Half ahead,
four.
Half ahead,
four. Downhill,
60 feet below the surface, Telemachus will take evasive action. Beyond the horizon, Force 75 steams to within striking range of the enemy. Armament trains onto the enemy. Above, turning with the turrets, director control tower is linked with transmitting station down below the waterline. Down here, out of the way of shell hits, reports pour in. Reports on the enemy's speed and estimated direction, Bellona's own speed, wind direction and density of the air, even the rotation of the earth. All these facts, fed into the Navy's secret calculators, tell the guns where the enemy will be by the time the shells land.
all panic. Lord, Lord, Lord.
From the bowels of the ship, hydraulic hoists bring up shell and cordite. The breach is closed.
Enemy in sight, bearing 330. Shoot!
Tutira to Bellona, operational, immediate. Enemy has altered course to the southern. My position, 170, Cape Brett, 30 miles. The decoded message goes to the plot room, where the relative course and position of Bellona and the enemy are worked out.
Plot, this is the captain. Stand by to carry out torpedo attack.
Planes report enemy crippled, but her guns may still be firing. Bellona must race in as close as she can, fire her torpedoes, and get away. From the bridge, the captain orders 30 knots.
Stand by torpedoes, starboard line.
Through the water at 40 knots to the destruction of the enemy. Late in the afternoon, planes are returning home from their last sortie, and the carrier steams into the wind to receive them. Last plane on, the flagship prepares to enter harbour. Under the command of Rear Admiral Eccles, Royal Navy, Force 75 has exercised officers and men on the surface, underwater, and in the air, maintaining the fighting efficiency of our two Commonwealth navies. In the Bay of Islands, northern New Zealand, buglers sound off sunset and white ensigns are lowered. The two navies now sail independently, some ships to patrol the Pacific, others to join the British and American naval forces, supporting the Security Council's resolution to help southern Korea. By sending immediate aid, New Zealand and Australia honor their obligations under United Nations Charter to maintain international peace and security.